Honorable members of the Legislative Assembly, Vanakkam. I deem it a great privilege to address the first session of the Tamil Nadu Legislative Assembly for the year 2021. I extend my New Year and Pongal greeting to each one of you. This is the concluding session of the 15th Legislative Assembly, and I take this opportunity to thank the honorable members of this august house for their substantial contribution to the development of Tamil Nadu through constructive discussions and debate for many sessions. This government, under the able stewardship of Honorable Chief Minister Thiru Edappadi ke Palaniswamy, continues to be guided by the spirit of the late Honorable Chief Minister Purachi Thalaivi Dr. J. Jayalalitha, and has made tremendous strides towards realizing the vision of making Tamil Nadu the numero uno state in the country. We are meeting today in the most unusual and unprecedented circumstances. The world has been struck by the most extensive pandemic in living memory. It is to the immense credit of the Honorable Chief Minister that the entire government machinery has been effectively mobilized to respond to the COVID-19 pandemic. A series of timely and effective measures have been taken. The lockdown was enforced from March 2020 to break the transmission chain of the disease while ensuring availability of essential supplies. Carefully calibrated relaxations were permitted during the lockdown. Effective disease surveillance through fever camps and testing and tracking measures were ensured. Health infrastructure was strengthened, human resources were augmented, and effective treatment protocols were adopted. RT-PCR test kits, medical equipment, PPE kits, quality drugs, and medicines were made available in adequate quantity. Tamil Nadu is the only major state in the country that has relied on an exclusive RT-PCR based testing strategy. Despite the higher cost, this has ensured that the incidence of the disease was correctly detected and further spread contained. The investment by this government in public health infrastructure and services have paid rich dividends in tackling the COVID-19 pandemic. health infrastructure was scaled up to meet the requirement, and 1,38,309 additional bed capacity was created in hospitals and COVID health care centers. Oxygen support was extended to 34,849 beds. All these measures have ensured that Tamil Nadu continues to perform very creditably in controlling the spread of the disease and minimizing the loss of lives, not just among the states in India, but even at the global level. The Honorable Chief Minister has also maintained continued vigil against a fresh flare-up of the disease. I commend the Honorable Chief Minister, the Council of Ministers, and the entire government machinery, and in particular, frontline workers of the health, revenue, police, local bodies, and other departments who have tirelessly worked as a team to combat the COVID-19 pandemic in Tamil Nadu. I would like to place on record my appreciation of the Honorable Chief Minister for his announcement that the entire population of Tamil Nadu would be vaccinated against COVID. The delivery of the vaccine has been smoothly rolled out across the state, in the first instance to healthcare workers who are in the front line of the battle against COVID-19. In the next stage, other frontline workers and the most vulnerable would be provided with the vaccine. Government will cover the entire population in due course so that normal social and economic activity can be fully resumed. The government has come out with two path-breaking initiatives. The auspicious legislation reserving 7.5% of government seats in MBBS, BDS, Indian medicine and homeopathy courses for students who have studied from 6th to 12th standard in state government schools and qualified in the NEET examination is a significant advancement of social justice and equity. It is heartening to note that 435 students have benefited this year. The government further undertook to defray the entire cost of education and hostel accommodation of these students. This will greatly motivate students in government schools who are from the poorer socio-economic background to aspire for medical education. It will also create a pool of medical professionals willing to serve in remote rural areas of the state. The Honorable Chief Minister launched the scheme establishing 2,000 Chief Ministers Amma Mini Clinics, which provide free primary health care in remote rural areas and in urban slums. This is already being lauded as a visionary model scheme worthy of emulation. The Honorable Chief Minister deserves special commendation of these two initiatives. The consistent focus of this government providing good governance to the people is now widely recognized. Apart from securing the first position in the Good Governance Index released by the Government of India for the first time last year, Tamil Nadu has been adjudged the overall best performing state for the third consecutive year in the State of the States survey carried out by the India Today magazine in November 2020. This award truly recognizes and highlights the pragmatic, efficient and effective style of governance of the Honorable Chief Minister. I congratulate him and the entire government machinery functioning under him on the accolades that the state continues to win at the national level. Responsiveness in governance is the watchword of this government. Many grievance redressal mechanisms, including the Amma Thittam, the Chief Minister Special Grievance Redressal and Taluk Online Petition Monitoring System and the Amma Call Center are currently functioning. A new integrated and inclusive public grievance Chief Minister Helpline Management System is being established. This will integrate all the existing grievance redressal system through the Chief Minister Call Center Helpline with a robust routing mechanism and a dashboard for follow-up. time-bound redressal of all grievances will be ensured. Citizens will very soon be able to access the government from the comfort of their homes by calling the Chief Minister helpline at 11 hours. Law and order at number 1100. Law and order is the highest priority of the government. Police department's role in tackling the pandemic, especially in contact tracing and in effective enforcement of the lockdown and of containment zones, was particularly significant. Even as the police was fully deployed in enforcing the restriction, law and order continued to be maintained well through adequate precautionary measures and by speedy follow-up of intelligent inputs. Untoward incidents were prevented. The police machinery in the state is fully geared to face all challenges, including the orderly conduct of elections to the Legislative Assembly. Promoting the glory of Tamil language is the foremost goal of this government. To honor the efforts of those who struggled for the inclusion of Tamil-speaking areas into Tamil Nadu, their monthly financial assistance has been increased from 4,500 rupees to 5,500 rupees, and for their legal heirs from 2,500 rupees to 3,000 rupees. The monthly financial assistance paid to Tamil scholars has been enhanced from 3,500 rupees to 4,500 rupees. For their legal heirs from 2,000 rupees to 2,500 rupees. The excavations at Kiladi have yielded rich material remains of the Sangam Age culture, and the major artifacts will be displayed in a world-class site museum that is being constructed by the government of Tamil Nadu. 385,788 words have been uploaded so far in the Surkulai Valaithalam. The State Official Language Commission has so far translated 38 Centres Acts into Tamil and is preparing a law lexicon in Tamil, in which more than 10,000 words have been compiled so far. The Ninaivu Mandapam, befitting the legacy of the late Honorable Chief Minister Dr. Selvi Jayalalitha, has been thrown open to the public. The residence of the late Honorable Chief Minister Vedanilayam has been taken over by the government and converted into a memorial through a special legislation and has been inaugurated. Commemorating the late Honorable Chief Minister's remarkable contribution to the field of education, the Tamil Nadu State Council for Higher Education campus has been named as the Dr. J. Jayalalitha campus, and a 9-foot bronze statue of the late Honorable Chief Minister has been installed there. The birthday of the late Honorable Chief Minister Dr. Selvi Jayalalitha will be observed as a government function every year. The 2020-21 financial began with a substantial slowdown in economic growth due to the COVID-19 pandemic and the measures taken to contain spread of the disease. In spite of sharply contracting revenues and large additional expenditure requirement, fiscal situation in this difficult period has been managed deftly. Expenditure on the COVID-19 response, upgrading health infrastructure and on capital works has been stepped up through reprioritizing the government has incurred a total expenditure of 13,208 crore rupees so far on COVID-19 relief and response measures from its own resources. Unlike many other states, Tamil Nadu did not delay or reduce salary payment to its employees. By restoring to timely and cost-efficient borrowing, government has protected the people of this state from the further adverse impact of COVID-19 pandemic. Tamil Nadu played a key role in the GST Council resolving the deadlock on payment of compensation to the states on account of the implementation of the GST. Even in this very difficult financial year, this government has obtained 13,300 crore rupees so far as GST compensation, which includes 4,890 crore rupees received as borrowing in lieu of compensation as per the mechanism put in place by the GST Council. It is a matter of satisfaction that the error that occurred in 2017-18 in the IGST allocation between the centre and the state has been rectified, and this year Tamil Nadu has finally received its dues of 4,321 crore rupees. The government appointed a high-level expert committee under the chairmanship of Dr. C. Rangarajan, former governor of the Reserve Bank of India and former chairman of the Prime Minister's Economic Advisory Council, to recommend a series of measures to help important sector of the economy overcome the impact of the COVID-19 pandemic and to support and promote further growth. This government action on many recommendations of the high-level committee report is having a favorable impact on economic growth. We are already seeing strong signs of revival in the economy. With the proactive approach of the government to encourage investment in sectors critical to the pandemic response like medical equipment, protective clothing, drugs and pharmaceuticals, and the efforts to attract investors seeking to relocate in the aftermath of the pandemic, Tamil Nadu was able to attract unprecedented 60,674 crore rupees worth of investment through 73 memoranda of understanding, generating employment or 1,07,21 persons, even during the pandemic period. Tamil Nadu received the highest share of investment proposal, 16%, in India during April to September 2020, as per the CARE rating report. Tamil Nadu has been ranked first by Project Today in attracting investment during the first two quarters of the COVID-19 pandemic period. This reflects the continued confidence that investors have reposed in Tamil Nadu and forms the foundation for the strong and sustained rebound of economic growth in the state. Tamil Nadu was struck by two cyclonic storms, Nivar and Burevi, in the year 2020. We have also had unseasonal heavy rainfall in January, which has affected crops on the verge of harvest. The proactive measures taken by the government ensured that the loss of lives and damage of property were minimized. The need of all the affected people were immediately attended to, and essential services were maintained with minimal disruption. These efforts of the government came in for well-deserved appreciation in the media and amongst the general public. I commend the Honorable Chief Minister for his personal leadership in organizing the relief work. The government of Tamil Nadu has presented two memoranda detailing the damages caused by two cyclones amounting to 3,750 crore rupees and 1,514 crore rupees respectively, and we urge the government of India to release funds at the earliest. Even without waiting for the release of central funds, the state government has sanctioned 20,000 rupees per hectare as input subsidy for paddy and 10,000 rupees per hectare for dry crop. Without limiting the amount of relief payable to all farmers who have suffered severe crop damages, a total amount of 1,715 crore rupees is being disbursed directly to the bank account of 16.71 lakh farmers affected by the two cyclones and the unseasonal rain in January. This timely assistance has enabled farmers to overcome their distress. The Honorable Chief Minister on 23rd March 2020 announced cash assistance of 1,000 rupees to every family with a rice ration card throughout the state to help tide over the lockdowns subsequently. Further cash assistance was provided to 28,31,535 rice option family card holders in Chennai and its surrounding areas and in Madurai city when an intensive lockdown was declared in the month of June 2020. cash assistance of 476 crore rupees was also distributed to 23,13,957 members of unorganized sector welfare boards. Based on the Honorable Chief Minister's announcement, a further cash assistance of 2,500 rupees along with a Pongal gift hamper has been provided to every family in the state, with a rice ration card to provide succor to the populace which was suffered the impact of the COVID-19 pandemic and the two cyclone storms and seasonal rains. This enabled all families in the state celebrate the Pongal festival joyously and provided a much needed consumption boost to the economy. This cash assistance was in line with the recommendation of Dr. C. Rangarajan Committee. This government will continue to staunchly protect Tamil Nadu's interest in interstate river waters issues. It was the strong initiative of this government which led to the effective implementation of the final order of the Kaveri Water Dispute Tribunal and the judgment of the Supreme Court, with the Government of India notifying the Kaveri Water Management Scheme 2018, comprising of Kaveri Water Management Authority and Kaveri Regulation Committee on 1/6/2018. We have emphatically reiterated to the Government of India that Karnataka should not be permitted to construct any reservoir or diversion structure across the river Kaveri and its tributaries in violation of the judgment of the Honorable Supreme Court and without the prior consent of Tamil Nadu. I again urge the Government of India to reject the Mekadatu project proposed by Karnataka, which is in violation of the judgment of the Honorable Supreme Court. We urge the Government of India that Kerala should not be allowed to construct any new dam across Periyar River in violation of the judgment of the Honorable Supreme Court. This government requests the Government of Kerala and the Government of India to quickly accord the requisite credentials for carrying out the remaining work for strengthening the Mullai Periyar Dam due to the initiatives of the Honorable Chief Minister. A negotiation at the official level to reach an amicable agreement on the Parambikulam Aliyar project and other river water issues with Kerala are progressing. As directed by the Honorable Supreme Court in the suit filed by Tamil Nadu, we have requested the Government of India constitute a tribunal under the provisions of the Interstate River Water Dispute Act 1956 to adjudicate the Paniyar River water dispute. This government, under the leadership of the Honorable Chief Minister, has focused on conserving and effectively utilizing the scarce water resources of Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu has been awarded the National Water Award 2019 by the Ministry of Jal Shakti as the best performing state. This is a well-deserved recognition for the initiatives undertaken under the Tamil Nadu Water Resources Conservation and Augmentation Mission, including the hugely popular Kudim Ramath scheme. Since 2017-18, 6,211 works have been taken up under the Kudim Ramath scheme at an estimated cost of 1,418 crore rupees. A part of the government's effort to modernize irrigation system in Tamil Nadu, government has accorded approval for the extension, renovation and modernization of Grand Nayakat canal system at an estimated cost of 2,639 crore rupees with funding from Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank. Sanction has been accorded for extension, renovation and modernization of the lower Bhavani project at a cost of 933 crore rupees, which will benefit 2.47 lakh acres of irrigated land. The implementation of the Nadanthai Wali Kaveri project has also commenced with the laying of the foundation stone for the construction of Nanjai Pugalur check dam across the river Kaveri at a cost of 406 crore rupees. Work on the Kaveri South Vellar link, which is the first stage of the Kaveri Gundar link, will be commenced shortly. This government has sanctioned the long pending Athikadu Avinashi lift irrigation scheme at a cost of 1,652 crore rupees. The work are progressing rapidly and the first phase will be completed before March 2021. Similarly, the Sarvanga lift irrigation scheme taken up at a cost of 565 crore rupees to recharge 100 dry tank with surplus water from Mettur Dam is expected to be completed by the end of March 2021. This government has taken a number of effective measures to protect the interest of our farmers. The Tamil Nadu Protected Agriculture Zone Development Act will protect fertile agricultural land and safeguard the livelihoods of farmers and agricultural laborers in the Kaveri Delta. Through this historic enactment, the Honorable Chief Minister fulfilled a long-standing demand of the Kaveri Delta region and has rightly earned the title of Kaveri Kapalan. After 8 years, Mettur Dam was opened on the due date of 12th June for Kuruvai paddy cultivation. A total amount of 9,312 crore rupees has been paid to farmers as compensation for crop losses in the last 4 years under the Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana to enable farmers in the state continue getting the protection of crop insurance. The government shouldering substantial additional financial burden implement the revamped Prime Minister Fasal Bima Yojana in 2020-2021. Even in a context where the implementation of this scheme has been halted in many states, Tamil Nadu is the leading state in the implementation of micro-irrigation in the country, and micro-irrigation systems have been established over an area 6.52 lakh acre 2019-20 with a total subsidy of 1,112 crore rupees to enhance water use efficiency. The initiatives of this government since 2011 have resulted in the structural transformation of the rural economy, greatly enhancing the share of the livestock sector in gross state domestic product. Today, 1,06,277 poor rural women have received 1,06,277 milch cows and 12,44,010 rural families have received 49,76,040 goats and sheep since 2011, and 3,60,620 families have received 1,09,40,500 birds in poultry units since 2018. The increase in the number of livestock has been backed by linkages to ensure enhanced and continued availability of fodder, feed, improved veterinary care, and substantial marketing arrangements. The government has established 3 more veterinary colleges at Talaivasal, Theni, and Udumalpet. The establishment of the Advanced Integrated Institute for Research in Livestock and Animal Sciences at Talaivasal, Salem district, which is a landmark achievement of this government, progressing rapidly, and the institute will be functional very soon. This government is fully committed to protect the traditional fishing rights of our fishermen in their historic fishing waters. This government strongly condemns the incident in which 4 fishermen of Tamil Nadu lost their life when a Sri Lankan naval vessel deliberately collided with their fishing vessel while the fishermen were engaged peacefully in fishing in their traditional waters. This government has announced a compensation of 10 lakh rupees for each deceased fisherman's family and a government-related job for a legal heir of the deceased fisherman. We have strongly urged the government of India to take up this issue with the Sri Lankan authorities. The government continues to take proactive measures to bring back the remaining 12 fishermen in Sri Lankan custody. Promoting deep sea fishing to enable Tamil Nadu fishermen to take advantage of the exclusive economic zone of 200 nautical miles is an important priority. Deep sea fishing boats are currently under construction, and onshore infrastructure including fishing harbors, fish landing centers, cold storage, marketing facilities are being rapidly developed. Fishing harbors at Thengapattinam at a cost of 97 crore rupees, Mukaiyur at a cost of 129 crore rupees, and Pumpuhar at a cost of 178 crore rupees, and a fish landing center at Kunthukal at a cost of 70 crore rupees have been completed. The construction of fishing harbors at Thiruvottiyur, Kuppam at a cost of 200 crore rupees, Sarangamwadi at a cost of 120 crore, Vellapallam at a cost of 100 crore rupees, and at Mudunagar at a cost of 100 crore rupees is progressing rapidly. Financial support has been tied up to construct fishing harbour at Alagankuppam, Alamparai Kuppam and Arkottuthurai at a total cost of 385 crore rupees. The government has undertaken a number of measures to ensure the safety of fishermen in the deep sea. A seamless satellite-based communication system has been established with the assistance of ISRO, the Marine Enforcement Wing, with 112 police personnel under the Department of Fisheries has been created. I am happy to inform the Sagas House that Tamil Nadu has implemented the One Nation, One Ration Card system, which will greatly benefit poor families who migrate in search of jobs, both within and outside the state, to draw their rations. As a measure of COVID relief, 19.95 lakh metric tons additional free rice was supplied to all ration card holders. Dal, palm oil and sugar as per entitlement were also supplied free of cost to all ration card holders in the state from April 2020 to July 2020. The state government took on an additional subsidy burden of 5,402 crore rupees for these measures. As you are well aware, Tamil Nadu is leading destination for investment. Out of the 304 memoranda of understanding signed in the Global Investors Meet 2019, 81 projects have commenced commercial production and 191 projects are at various stages of implementation. Since the Global Investors Meet 2019, Tamil Nadu has attracted investment into 149 more projects with a cumulative investment of 1,06,604.60 crore rupees, offering employment to 2,42,705 persons. I compliment the Honorable Chief Minister for this direct involvement and proactive efforts in attracting investment such a large scale even during the COVID-19 pandemic. To encourage investment in sunrise sectors, the government has announced an electric vehicle policy and an electronic hardware manufacturing policy, which are both proven to be attractive. The new industrial policy has been approved by the government and will be unveiled shortly, providing a further fillip to industrial growth. The micro, small and medium enterprises in Tamil Nadu are not only a nursery of entrepreneurship, but also provide employment to large numbers. Tamil Nadu had 23.6 lakh registered units with a total investment of 2,73,241 crore rupees, providing employment to 1.52 crore persons. The new MSME policy has been finalized after consultation with multiple stakeholders and will be released by the Honorable Chief Minister shortly in order to help MSMEs tide over the COVID-19 pandemic. The government front-loaded release of different kinds of subsidies and coordinated effectively with bank and financial institutions to ensure MSME units in Tamil Nadu benefit through the Government of India's Emergency Credit Line Guarantee Scheme. To facilitate quick access to loans under the ECLG scheme and to provide relief to MSMEs, the government exempted payment of stamp duty for registration of agreement relating to memorandum of deposit of the title deeds for the period up to 31st March 2021. The registration fee was reduced to 0.1% from 1% for such an agreement for micro and small enterprises. To further ease access to formal credit, the government will amend the Registration Act 1908 to permit online registration of agreements relating to memorandum of deposit of title deeds for availing term loan and working capital loans, and do away with the need for the physical presence of borrowers and lenders for execution of such deeds. The Honorable Chief Minister personally convened a special state-level bankers committee meeting during the pandemic to exhort bankers to lend to MSMEs to enable them to overcome the crisis. Due to these proactive measures, Tamil Nadu had the highest availment amongst all states under the ECLG scheme. The government will infuse fresh additional capital of 1,000 crore rupees over 3 years into the Tamil Nadu Industrial Investment Corporation to enable TIC to function as an effective term lending institution, and also expand lending operations and cover the large number of MSME units that still do not have access to institutional credit. Tamil Nadu, which is at the forefront of utilizing information and communication technology to ensure enhanced public service delivery, was awarded the Gold Award by the President of India in the Excellence in Digital Governance category at the Digital India Award 2020. Large ICT projects, back-end computerization have been effectively implemented, including an integrated financial and human resources management system project, which has been successfully rolled out throughout the state. The Tamil Nadu blockchain policy aims to introduce frontline technology in the e-governance structure of the state. With Tamil Nadu's blockchain backbone, Nambikai, NIM, enabling a seamless and secure delivery of various government services, the Tamil Nadu policy for safe and ethical artificial intelligence aims to make Tamil Nadu a hub for artificial intelligence technology companies and investments. Government is also committed to ensure the highest standards of security and privacy of data through the recently released cyber security policy. The BharatNet project will be rolled out to 1/3 of the revenue villages in the state by 31st March 2021 and to the remaining villages by 30th November 2021. By combining BharatNet with TN-SWAN, TamilNet and TechTVs, broadcast infrastructure, convergent digital service delivery platform, unified digital infrastructure will be built to deliver high-speed, scalable bandwidth to all households in the state. A key element of infrastructure in Tamil Nadu is the supply of a quality and reliable power to all consumers. State continues to be power surplus. In the past 10 years, 15,745 megawatt of generation capacity has been added to reach a total installed capacity of 30,145 megawatt. Of this, 16,166 megawatt of power is renewable energy capacity, including hydroelectric power. Large investments have also been made to enhance the capacity of both the transmission and distribution network to ensure reliable supply of power. The high-quality road network of Tamil Nadu sustains economic growth. To improve traffic flow in important cities, including Chennai, Coimbatore, and Madurai, flyovers and grade separators have been taken up. To provide congestion-free access to Coimbatore city, elevated flyover from Goldwins to Upilialayam has been sanctioned at an estimated cost of 1,620 crore rupees. Tamil Nadu Road Sector Project Phase 2 with World Bank assistance, Chennai Peripheral Road Project with JICA and AIIB assistance, and Chennai Kanyakumari Industrial Corridor Project with ADB assistance are being taken up. Road safety continues to be the highest priority for the state government. And due to concentrated efforts, the trend of reducing the number of road accidents and fatal road accidents has continued, with the total number of accidents declining from 71,431 in 2016 to 45,489 in 2020, and fatal accident declining from 17,218 in 2016 to 8,060 in 2020. Tamil Nadu has won the award for the best state reducing fatal accidents for the year 2018 and 2019. The government is committed to further increasing the ridership share of public transportation in the state by improving the quality of bus transport while maintaining fares at an affordable level. As a result of the COVID-19 pandemic, there were severe restrictions on the operation of bus transport. The operation of the Transport Corporation are slowly returning to normal with adherence to all precaution to control the spread of the virus. Passenger service in the extension of Phase 1 of the Chennai Metro Rail project from Vasarmanpet to Vimkunagar will be inaugurated by the Honorable Prime Minister later this month. The foundation stone for the 118.9 kilometer long Chennai Metro Rail project Phase 2 at an estimated cost of 61,843 crore rupees was laid by the Honorable Union Home Minister. The financing for the project has been tied up with JICA, ADB, AIIB and the New Development Bank. We are urging the Government of India to accord formal approval for their equity participation on the 50-50 sharing model for Phase 2 of the project. The urban local bodies in Tamil Nadu have been at the forefront of the control of COVID-19 pandemic. The various urban infrastructure programs funded by the central and the state government and external aid agencies are being implemented with vigor. Recycling and reuse of wastewater for recharging of urban water bodies is being taken up in a systematic manner, in addition to the two existing 45 MLD tertiary treatment reserve osmosis plants to 10 MLD sewage tertiary treatment ultra-filtration plants are under construction at Perungudi and Nerupakkam and Nespakkam to recharge Perugundi and Poru lakes. This government is committed to providing quality housing to the poorest households in urban and rural areas. Each poor family without a house will be provided a concrete roofed house in rural areas and apartment in a multi-storied building in urban area. A special additional allocation, 70,000 rupees per house in the rural area, taken up under the Prime Minister Awas Yojana, has been sanctioned, which would enable the speedy completion of 2,57,925 houses under construction in rural areas of the state. With this, as against the unit cost of 1,20,000 rupees per house, approved by the Government of India, under the PMAY Grameen, the unit cost in Tamil Nadu would be 2,40,000 rupees, with the state government share at 1,68,000 rupees per house. The Tamil Nadu Affordable Urban Housing and Habitat Policy has been formulated to expand access to housing in urban areas. The government has also mobilized financing from the World Bank and Asian Development Bank for urban housing in the state. With simplification of rules and enhanced delegation of powers, the process of granting plan permissions has been considerably speeded up. Through the regularization scheme for unapproved layouts, 39,939 layouts and 21.86 lakhs plots have been regularized based on widespread demand to cover left out cases. The last date for application for regularizing layouts, which had been formed on or before 20th October 2016, has been extended till 28th February 2021. Protecting forests and increasing tree cover is the highest priority of this government. Tamil Nadu achieved an increase of 8,302 hectares in forest area and 159 square kilometers of tree cover between 2017 and 2019. As per the India State of Forest Report 2019, the state has achieved the second rank in India in forestry diversity. Protecting the habitat for wildlife has resulted in an increase in tiger population from 2014 to 64 in 2018. Translating Tamil Nadu's demographic dividend into progress and prosperity requires the potential of youth to be fully developed. Hence, education continues to be very high priority. Investment for this state since 2017-18, 19 new government arts and science colleges, 5 government polytechnic colleges, 3 university constituent colleges have been established. In addition, a large number of new courses have been commenced each of these colleges, and investments have been made to upgrade quality in universities and colleges. To facilitate online classes, 9.69 lakh student government-aided colleges and those receiving scholarships in self-financing colleges have been provided a data SIM card, 2 GB per day capacity for 4 months up to April 2021. The challenge in the current academic year has been to ensure that there is no loss of continuity in children's education. Various benefits that school children receive, including the nutritious noon meal, textbooks, notebooks, and school supplies, are being distributed to them through the pandemic period. The government has taken a number of measures to ensure that students are able to access education content through Kalvi TV and 10 private TV channels. The free distribution of laptops scheme has been effectively leveraged by uploading video lessons through high-tech labs, and multiple internet platforms have been utilized to deliver digital content. The government has constituted 2 committees to examine the implications of the new education policy of the Government of India for school and higher education in the state. This government is fully committed to continuance of 2 language policy in the state, and there shall be no dilution in this regard. Skill development continues to be a high priority for the government, and the Apex Skill Development Centers in the auto components, machine tools, hospital and healthcare services, transportation and logistics sectors are now functional. A memorandum of understanding to establish the Apex Skill Development Center in the construction and infrastructure sector has also been signed. Over and above the ongoing centrally sponsored schemes, the Government of Tamil Nadu, from its own resources, has sanctioned a total amount of 682 crore rupees for the Tamil Nadu Skill Development Mission since 2013 and 2014. Tamil Nadu displayed compassion in handling migrant laborers during the COVID-19 pandemic. Free food was provided to lakhs of construction and other workers throughout the state. Dry ration kits were provided to 22,74,582 unorganized workers and interstate migrant workers. This government made the cost of repatriation of 4,03,042 migrant workers to their native places through special train services. A portal for interstate migrant workers has been developed at present, data relating to 3,60,368 interstate migrant workers in the Tamil Nadu has been uploaded. The compassionate treatment and effective relief measures have meant that many migrant workers have returned to their jobs in Tamil Nadu after the lockdown restrictions were lifted and continue to be important contributors to Tamil Nadu's economy. In order to enhance the welfare of workers in the firework and match industry, this government constituted the Tamil Nadu Fire and Match Workers Welfare Board on 30th December 2020. This government is firmly committed to improve the welfare of working women through the implementation of the Chief Minister's Girl Child Protection Scheme. Child sex ratio has improved. Special efforts have been taken to reduce crime against women and children by effective enforcement of legal provisions. Tamil Nadu Working Women Hostels Corporation Limited has been established to enhance availability of safe, quality and affordable accommodation for working women. The entire stage is being covered under the Tamil Nadu State Rural Livelihood Mission and National Urban Livelihood Mission. Under the Tamil Nadu State Rural Livelihood Mission, 14,000 crore rupees has been targeted for SHG bank credit linkages. A special COVID assistance package at a cost of 300 crore rupees has been implemented to assist 2,53,457 beneficiaries in 120 blocks under the Tamil Nadu Rural Transformation Project. Tamil Nadu has been a forerunner in protecting destitute elders, widows, differently abled persons, unmarried women, and deserted wives. Totally, 33,60,021 persons are receiving social security and old age pension. The Maintenance and Welfare of Parents and Senior Citizens Act 2007 is being effectively implemented, and 3,966 petitions seeking maintenance allowance have been disposed. A state action plan for senior citizens comprising 5 components will be implemented shortly. This government is committed to ensuring the full participation of differently abled persons in all realms of socio-economic activity. Special care was taken to ensure access to differently abled persons to their basic requirements during the lockdown period, and the maintenance assistance was paid 2 months in advance. A special cash assistance of 1,000 rupees was distributed to all differently abled persons holding national identity card, and 5,31,00,000 rupees worth of dry rations and medical kits were provided. Accessibility audit of all public offices is being taken up progressively. A special recruitment drive to fill the special quota of 4% in government establishment has been launched to clear backlog vacancies intended for the differently abled. This government will also continue to implement schemes for the economic development and social advancement of Adi Dravidians, scheduled tribes, backward and most backward classes, denotified communities and minorities. I thank the Government of India for restructuring the post-matric scholarship for scheduled caste on a 60-40 sharing basis, accepting the request of the Honorable Chief Minister. We expect that all students currently deriving benefit from the present scholarship scheme will continue to do so under the new scheme as well. Thai Pusam is an important festival of Tamil Nadu, and in response to a number of requests from the general public, the government has declared Thai Pusam as a public holiday. From 2011 to 2020, 11,464 temples were renovated and consecrated at a cost of 551 crore rupees. The retaining walls, Elaiya Kinara Temple tank in Elaiya in Chidambaram, which were damaged due to heavy rains in November-December 2020, are being reconstructed at an estimated cost of 2 crore and 61 lakh rupees. The retaining walls of the Nagori Durga tank in Nagapattam, which were damaged due to Nivar and Burevi cyclones, are being reconstructed at an estimated cost of 4 crore and 34 lakh rupees. The government has increased the financial assistance for undertaking Hajj and Jerusalem pilgrimage. State Minorities Commission will be expanded to suitable legislation to provide representation to linguistic minorities. The year 2020 is an unforgettable year in the history of mankind. We are bound to overcome the pandemic through will and determination. As a collective, the people of India and Tamil Nadu in particular have coped with this unprecedented crisis with the conviction that the year to come will see renewed progress and development. I use this occasion to place on record my heartfelt gratitude to the frontline staff and officials of the health, revenue police, local police, other government departments who have worked tirelessly during the period. The members of this house and all the citizens of the state who have contributed to the COVID pandemic response. I thank each one of you for your contribution. Tamil Nadu has emerged at the forefront in all sectors and has been commended as one of the best administered states in the country. The state has made tremendous strides in various fields and has won a large number of awards at the national level for exemplary performance. I congratulate and compliment the entire governmental machinery of the state of Tamil Nadu, led by the Honorable Chief Minister, for this exceptional performance. We are in the last session of the 15th Legislative Assembly of Tamil Nadu. On behalf of the government, I have outlined various policy initiatives and interventions. There are many achievements of which this government can be justifiably proud of. All members of this House have contributed to the democratic debate and deliberations over the last 5 years, thereby enriched the policy content and enabled effective implementation. I wish each one of you a very happy New Year 2021 and happy Pongal. Nandri Vanakkam, Jai Hind, Jai Tamil Nadu.